Co-parenting with a narcissistic ex can feel like you're walking into a trap, especially when it seems like they know just the right buttons to push. In today's episode, we're diving into the complexities of setting boundaries while co-parenting with a high conflict ex. Our listener is dealing with an ex-partner who seems to have narcissistic tendencies, and she doesn't use that term lightly. He often offers to do something really nice for her, but when she denies, he lashes out. And it's such a frustrating cycle because even though she can see the pattern, she gets pulled in and she gets so upset because it works almost every time. Let's listen to her message. Oh yeah, let me explain. So when you send us a boundary question, you can either DM us, you can email us, or you can also send us a voicemail. We have our very first voicemail and I am so excited. So even though I am battling a head cold, I couldn't wait because I'm like, oh my gosh, you can actually hear the listener's voice asking the question and it's not just my voice. So I couldn't wait and like get better. I had to do it today. So we are going to hear from her ourselves and then we're going to talk about strategies to help her break this cycle.
Hi, I am co-parenting with a man who is exhibiting some narcissistic red flag behavior, even though I want to use that word sparingly. I don't think he's a full-blown narcissist, but there's definitely some gaslighty kind of behavior and patterns, such as he will offer to do something for me that is not necessary, was not asked for, but he kind of insists. And when I decide to say no to these things, it immediately turns into a heated, antagonistic, like text war where we're both going at each other. I'm always looking for excuses as to why I don't need whatever it is that he's offering me, such as, you know, switching days so that my child could be with me on my birthday, even though it falls on a weekday, which is his day. And it feels like I'm being pressured into being more involved in his life. I'm really not sure what to make of it, but it's definitely crossing some boundaries with me. And I seem to fall for it every time I respond to the text messages. It just gets worse. I'd love any input you have. Thank you.
First, I want to acknowledge how frustrating this must be. It's one thing to know that someone's trying to get a reaction out of you, but the moment they push that perfect button, it's incredibly hard not to respond, especially if our kids are involved. And to be completely honest, our ex-partners are often experts at which button to push and what will get under our skin. So before we know it, they push the button and we're just drug right back into that negative cycle or the muck that we wanted to stay out of in the first place. If it were me, I would make it clear that while I appreciate everything he's doing or the offers that he's making, I'm gonna stick to the agreed upon schedule. So I would say something like, I appreciate that you're trying to be kind, but for my own well-being, I'm gonna stick to the schedule we have. I would also let him know going forward that you're not going to get into these texting battles. For example, if I decline your offer and then things start to get heated or get into an argument, I'm going to end the conversation there. I'm not going to respond once it starts going down that path because it's not good for either one of us. This statement is going to make it very clear that you're protecting your peace and setting a boundary around communication. He might react really strongly at first, especially if he's using these tactics to draw you in, but the main goal that you're going to want to focus on is consistency. Now, how you're going to mind your boundary. When he starts pulling you back in to those old patterns, that's your cue. That's your moment to reinforce your boundary. So as soon as the conversation starts going downhill, end it with something like, I'm going to stop here. Have a good night. Then put your phone down, put it on do not disturb, get busy. If your kids aren't with him and you can just like temporarily block him for a little bit, whatever you have to do so that you're not tempted to re-engage. Remember, consistency, consistency, consistency. He may push harder at first, just trying to regain that control, but through your actions, he's going to begin to understand, okay, this cycle is over and you're no longer going to participate in this negativity. Here's some additional tips. Number one, I would do check-ins, like self-check-ins. I would remind yourself that you don't have to respond instantly. Give yourself a moment, take a deep breath, and just think, okay, Do I need to respond to this? Do I really want to engage? Before you do anything, just take a beat. Number two, redirecting the focus. After you end the conversation, get busy. Do something positive. Be productive. Go for a walk. Do anything, but keep your mind off of the conversation so that you can reinforce the commitment to breaking the cycle. Number three, get a support system. If at all possible, talk with a trusted friend, a family member, anyone that can help hold you accountable for not engaging, especially at first. Like when you first start holding this line and minding your boundary, that's when the urge to still go into that familiar pattern is going to be the strongest. And so having that support system will really be valuable. Setting boundaries with an ex, especially one who has narcissistic tendencies, is challenging, but it's also possible. It takes time, but most importantly, consistency. Thank you so much for our listener for leaving us our very first voicemail, for asking the question, and I hope these strategies help you. And for others in our boundary community, if you've ever gone through something similar, I would love it, and I'm sure she would love hearing your valuable insights on how you broke these cycles yourself. Remember, we're all in this together. Now YouTube thinks you're gonna enjoy this video, and until next time, friends, make sure you keep minding your boundaries. Bye.